Okay, now, whilst we're waiting for the glue and all to dry, we can see about making a start on painting the signal arm, because once we have this signal arm fitted onto the signal, it will take, you know, it'll be a bit tricky in order to paint up the spectacles and also the arms and all for the signal. So, what we have here is, to paint it up, I've got some cocktail sticks for mixing the paint here. And also the paint itself. I'm using Humbrol colours for this kit. Some Tamiya masking tape and also a clean paintbrush. Now this one's a wee bit thicker than the one I was hoping to use, but it was the only one I had at the minute. So here these two here. Well, I've got some red for the main signal arm. We also got some green for the spectacle plate. And also some matte black for the black part of the arm. So, what we'll do first of all here is that we'll prepare the arm for painting. Just get it here. Now, what I think might work, just to keep it in place whilst we're painting, is that if I lay bit of masking tape here. Put the arm here at the back like that. And then this. Have a nice little fixing plate here so that the arm stays in place whilst we're painting it. And also what I should do here now is also take a bit of masking tape off here. Set it down here. And then get a steel rule. It's easy. Use this as a guidance here, that's a while, just to get the right length. Oh, right width anyway. Right, that looks about right. A wee thin strip off there. In fact, I'll just zoom the camera in here just so you guys can see what I'm doing here. I'm using an old tripod here for this. Apologies for the shakiness. So I'll just cut a small strip off masking tape there. So using this arm, this Great Western signal for guidance is the way to put it. There. It's a bit crooked. There we go. She's on. There. So that there will mask off the white area for the arm. Okay, now we'll begin painting. Now I'm going to start the red first. Now this is, I think this is Scarlet Red, Humbrol Acrylic number 19. I'm only using the only enamel paint is the black one. Now remember here that the acrylics will wash off with water, enamels will wash off with spirits. So just keep that in mind. So it's always best to shake the pot there first before you open it there. Make sure the paint's all nice and mixed. Which it is. And then put on your brush. And just very lightly paint the arm. Just making sure all is covered. Yeah. Okay, just let that sit for a wee bit. Then we'll move on to painting the black. For pinning the spectacle plates on the signal arm, I actually find these cocktail sticks quite handy. So what we'll do is I'll get our paint. So I'll go for the green first here. Yeah. Dip the tip in so you get like a little tiny bit on the end there, and then just tap it in place, and then that should actually, there we go, fill that spot up. Red again. Same thing again, just dip it in to the paint. And then just very lightly tap it in the spectacle. Go. Okay, and then we'll just let that dry off for a few hours, and then we'll come back to it and do the other side of the arm. Another thing which I've forgotten to add in here is to also about painting the wee lamp on the signal there, so using some black. I'll just And also, just do the top as well, just to sometimes these signals actually have the top parts of them in black. Okay, I'll just let that set to dry for a while. Okay, with the paint now dry here, I've removed the signal light, the signal arm from the wee masking tape holder. And I've also removed the tape that was masking for the stripe. And you can see now here that it's given a nice, clean finish to it there. So, now that's that side done here, then I can start on doing the other side. So, just very carefully, turn the signal arm over, and I might just actually make up another wee rig, just for this on. Let's see, where's that end? Now, I'm going to be securing only the black part of the signal arm to this now because parts of the red paint is still a bit wet, so just need just to be on the safe side, like. And that in there. Now, get some more tape to mask off this area. Now, let me see. Let's see where the red starts. Here should be in line with that one, and then to make the black part of the arm there. Also, just make sure that masking tape's fully secure, and just run over with the end of the cocktail stick, just to ensure that we have a good seal on the masking tape, so that everything, so that we don't have any paint seeping underneath, which I can admit happened a few times, one time ago, but now that's all changed. Okay, so get our black paint again. Areas. Right, whilst I have the black paint out, I can paint this little bit here, which will go at the back of the arm. It's also important that you get all of the plastic painted. Now, some of you will be asking me here, will probably be saying in the comments, some maybe the experts at railway modelling would probably be writing in the comment section, would you not have put primer on these signal arms first before you painted them? Well, I would, but because it's only a small area, a small item which I'm painting, I don't really actually need primer to paint these bits. But I would only use like primer if I'm using like painting up some like pretty large areas or large models to paint up. But for these wee signals, it doesn't really quite matter in my case. So okay, I'll let those dry for about 15 minutes or so. Then what I'll do is that I'm gonna spray the arm and also the post as well with a bit of spray varnish, which will just keep everything all nice and clean and tidy, and also to seal off any paint in case it may chip or so when it comes to the final assembly. Okay, so we'll come back to that there in a few minutes. Okay, that's the paint now dry for the back now of the signal. So that's now both sides of the signal now fully painted, and we can now see about getting it ready to fit it on to the post. Now, this is going to be quite tricky now here, because I have to make sure that how I go about doing this here is done correctly, and make sure the signal is working okay. Works fine once it's fully wired up. Okay, so I'll just put the signal arm to one side here. There we go. And what I'll do then is to cut out now the cut out this little gizmo here. Well, this is this is gonna be stuck underneath the signal post. And I think I might actually get, there's a set of wire cutters here in this set, this Wilson set, just to cut the spur off, because this is quite delicate, this bit. Right. There we go. And just cut away the excess plastic. Another file. There we go. Okay. Get a single post. You have to make sure that when you glue this in place here, make sure that these wee bits here are on the sides of the post. So, like that, when you put it like that. So, I'll just loosely test fit it there, see that all's nice and snug. Okay, that looks fine. So, yeah, poly cement again. Brush. Put that in place. And I just push fits in place. Again, just to ensure a good joint is made. Okay, so now we're going to attach the arm to the signal. And so, in order to do that, get our arm, and also some 1 pico track pin. This one's a bit bent here, so let's bend that, get my pliers, bend that back into shape. Now usually with, because I'm using a Great Western signal here, the hole to take the pin is actually a bit larger than the pin, but because the hole in the single arm is only small enough to accept this pin, I don't risk actually widening it. I could actually have a small bit of plastic tubing, just small enough there to accept this pin, and just glue it in inside there. But apparently, sadly, I don't actually have any of them, so I'll have to make do with this here. But at least then it'll make sure that the single arm operates freely and can turn easily. Okay, so what I'll do is I'll get single arm. Just very carefully, just push that pin through. Of course, the hole is, can be gummed up from the paint and all, so it'll just need to be a bit of clean light. The same thing will probably be done for when I'm putting the actual signal wire in the same way. Okay, just do that all the way through now. Come on, there we go, that's it. Right. Just through. Okay. Now, get item here. I'll add the sprue. Now I'm only going to test run this here now because I'm going to be adding the signal wire whilst I'm fitting this in place. So just actually put this through here. Also, it'll also help me experiment to see. It'll also help me experiment to see because at the back of the signal, you'll see here. I don't know if the camera can pick. Will focus on that pretty well. There we go. You can just make out that little bit of plastic there. That's just to keep that little spectacle. I've forgotten what you call those now, but that little black thing here, the wee back cap thing, just to hold that in place for when I'm either having the signal in danger or when it's being changed to all clear. Now, there's a video I actually have seen that Pico did, where they show you how to assemble the LMS kit, but not the Great Western one here, so I'll have to have a quick look at that there first, just so I know which way that spectacle has to go on this signal. So I'll be back with you in a wee minute here, just so I can just have a quick look over of that video. Okay, sorry about that there. I just had a quick look there at that video, and okay, so the I'll just turn this around here just so you guys can see it here, because I'm looking at it from a different view. This little item here, which is actually, it's actually called the it's not on camera. Oh, there we go. This item here, the spectacle plate, which is what it's called, that actually will sit upside down, like that, and the wee lip, the wee bit of plastic. Oops. Obviously, part of the paint is still not dry, but soon be once I get once to spray that varnish on it. Oh, come on, get off. But that little bit of plastic here, that'll actually, it'll be sitting on here, so that'll keep the signal in place once it's in there in the danger position. So what I'll do then is to get the signal wire and here. Now I'll just zoom out just a wee bit here, just so you guys can see what I'm doing here. Okay, so what I'll do is I'll get my signal wire, get my pliers, and then just take a small corner of it there, and then just make a small 90 degrees angle. Like that. Okay. And then just put that, throw that into back of the signal. Now, I don't know if it's meant to be at the front or the back. Again, I might have to look back at that video again, just to make sure I'm doing this correctly. Just take a little bit of it there, just make sure that I don't clog any paint that's blocking it. Seems to be fine. So then what I'll do then is that I'll thread the wire down this little, now because I have that little plate in place, that this little holder for the lever which will operate the signal here, there's, if you look carefully down there, you might see it there we go, you can see here that it's actually divided that little hole into two sections. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to thread in through on the left hand one, like so, and at the same time thread the pin through the rivet hole. So this gives me a chance to actually give a test view as to how the signal will operate once it's in the hole. There's a wee bit of jigging. There's a wee bit of jigging movement in there, but that's because the pin is, you know, it's still loosely in the hole. So I need to tighten that in place. Once I get the spectacle plate in place, where did I leave it? Oh yeah, stuck in my hand. Right, spectacle plate. Where are you? Okay, now move that into horizontal position. Spectacle plate, then just push it in, push it. There's a small hole in here now, so I have to make sure that it's going in. Okay, oop, thought I lost it there for a sec. Okay, now I have to be, to look very carefully at this one right here, so forgive me if I go quiet for a second, because I'm just concentrating that this goes in correctly. A bit of paint coming up that wee hole here, so what I'll do is I'll get another pin. I've got plenty of pins here, so awkward here, so. Because you will encounter problems like this when you're building your kits. Again. There we go. So missing just okay. Now, in the instructions, some instructions that they give you when fitting these ones in, they always say to cut off that excess bit of pin here. But what I'm going to do first, I'm just going to get a bit of glue, a bit of point, just so I can. Just a little brush, just so that what it does, it'll. The glue will soften up just a wee bit there, but it'll also tighten up the hole so that the pin doesn't, slide out at all. Okay, just let that set for a wee bit there. Yeah. In fact, I just realised I put the spectacle plate the wrong way around. Oh, God heavens. Okay, it might be back in just a few sec here. Okay, with that little blunder fixed up, you got the spectacle plate now in the right place now. The glue's just about dried. And now we can just snip off the excess pin with the wire cutters. What is that? Just in case. Yeah, there we go, just bring the pin slightly. Not cutting really all that much off the pin really, just in case that. There we go. Just in case that spectacle plate comes out again. But just for extra measures, I might put a wee bit of super glue on that there. Just a little tiny blob, and then that'll just keep it in place there. Okay, so that's that part done. There's a wee bit of paint has come off from the single, but that don't worry about that. I'm not really fussed about it here, because what that actually would give the good impression of is like probably maybe the paint chipping off of, like, you know, the real life signal. So again, weathering wise, so it just shows, like, you know, the bare metal underneath the arm. So now then, what I'll do here now is just get a bit of masking tape here, just to hold the wire in place whilst I'm doing this part of the construction, where we're making the mechanism, getting the lever at all for the signal in order to make it work. So I'm going to keep the signal at danger for this part, just so it's all nice and aligned. There we go. Just keep that in place there for now. Okay, now we need to get the wee little mechanism. Now this is actually for holding on to a spring which will operate the signal. What the spring does is that it actually makes the signal go back to its to the position I want it to, that I started off from. So that's there, removed from the spirit. Just realised I had the glue thing off. Now the spring is in the little packet where we had the other signal arm from the kit. So we'll just get that out. Let's see, where are you? Here we are. Now, when you're fitting this into place on this little gizmo, there's a part here that you need to be very, very aware of. Now, inside here, now if you see this bottom part here, I'll just get a cocktail suit to show you. Right, in this bottom part here, not that hole, because that's where I'm going to have the string to feed up. But there's another little stud here. Now inside that there's a small hole. Now I don't think the camera will pick that up. Maybe it just might there. I don't know. If you can see a small hole just projecting through there, what you need is that you have to thread part of the spring in that, and then the loop will go across. The loop will sit on this bit here. So I'll just show you there. So here's a spring, and then just thread it through this bit here. It's a bit tricky this here, but there. And then just loop that on top. So that's our spring now in place. So you can see now here there's a wee bit of tension on that there. That's going to be our spring. So then get our signal. And then you just put it in place like that. And then to activate the spring of it, you just put this part here, rest on top of that bit there. Like so. So that will create a big spring. Okay. Now, what it's done now here is that once the spring is on, it's now gone to the position where I'll need the signal to move to all clear. So, in order to do that, I'll just have to pull on the wire carefully. Okay, so that's the signal. Now I set it all clear. Spring's come off. Yeah, I'm keeping a careful eye on that spectacle plate, because okay, everything seems to be okay there. Okay, move to that all clear. Put the spring on. Now, I'll have to mark out where exactly I'll have to bend the wire in order to fit through this little hole here. So what I'll do is I'll create another bend in the wire, just about there. So, oops, ooh, careful, careful. And then just and just cut off the excess wire. There we go. Now, what I'll do now here is I'll get the masking tape, cut it off. Again, apologies for keeping quiet here, because again, once the thing about modeling here is you have to be very quiet to anything that's being played in the background. Just isolate it from your mind. Just keep focused on what you're doing. Okay, that's that tape removed. So what I'm going to do is just try out, see how the signal will operate. It seems to be okay. Might need to experiment a wee bit more with it there, but so far so good. So far so good with that. Still think that hole in the arm is a wee bit too big for that there, because I can feel it jiggling about a wee bit. But I'll try and see if I might get, I'll see if I can get that fixed at some stage. But anyway, that's roughly sorted now for that. Oh, the springs are in the wrong place. There we go, that's it. Okay. So then, I just keep dropping it for some reason, I don't know why. Shouldn't be laughing. Anyway. Back on again. Oh, come on today. In fact, I might actually bend that just a little bit more, because I think that's slacking a wee bit. Where's the clip? Spring in place. Right, that'll have to do. Okay. Then to secure it, make sure the thing doesn't fall out, like it's done a few times. Get this wee tube. And then try and push that in, and that'll hold thing in place. So I'll be back in a few minutes. Okay, whilst we're away here, I've put this little tube in place here. This is to keep the little mechanisms in place underneath the signal. And also, what I've also done is I also put a wee small dab of superglue on the spectacle plate just on the back there, just to make sure it keeps the pin in place and stops it jiggling about. Worth keeping in mind here when you're making these kits here. They don't really tell you much in the instructions, I don't think so, but just bear in mind just to glue that in place once you're doing that there. So, does the signal work? Let's have a look. So, that's it all clear. Maybe the little mechanism of the thing. Goes danger, all clear, danger, all clear. There's a wee bit of a bendiness here of the wire, but that's something. I may have bent it a wee bit slack at some areas there, or maybe a bit too much, but it wouldn't matter as much there. It's okay now, but that's the signal now working. That's good. So next thing we do now is the signal lever. So, is it just from the sprue? Just start cutting away here, away from the sprue here. So there's another little tube here that will hold the mechanism in place. That's one of the sides. Now, get the other side here. There we go. Get the lever. Here to hold the swing. Now, this little bit here which I've left, this is an important item if you're going to use the method that this kit operates with. What this does is that it's just helpful for tying the string so that you can adjust the tightness of the string. So I'm going to keep this in mind, just keep this to one side here so that I don't lose it. In fact, I might keep it in the box so that I'll know where it is. Anyway. Here are components for the signal lever, and what we'll do is just a very simple structure. Just zoom in here so you can see. So you got one of these sides here which got a few studs now coming up here, so that'll just threaten like that there. So there's your little lever, based good design with to keep them. Here practical with the original signal lever prototypes. So then what you do is you just slot it in there like thus. And then you get the other one. And there's a little lock, these kind of join together in some ways in a way, so place. So once I move the lever here, that can does that. Then to secure it in place, get the other plate. That's it. Just get it in place there, like thus. And then little cover, make sure everything's all secured in place, and that just slots in like so. So there's your single lever, all set to go. And it's also got interlocking a wee bit. Just there's little studs in that there, so that change it, you can just lock into that there. So there you go. So that's pretty much the signal kit done, and I'll have to see about making two more kits, as well as this one, which is the bracket signal. Now, I won't show you guys how to do this one, because this one's going to be a very tricky one to do now. So, but I'll show you the aftermath later on, in another vlog. So, but yeah, it pretty much uses the same principles as this signal kit here. So, what I'll do then is I'll drill a hole in the baseboard, about 13 millimeters or so, or maybe inches, I think. Let me just see here. It should say here how wide the hole should be, actually. Basically, it's about half inch diameter holes through the baseboard for the signal, and the other one for the lever. So that's pretty much it. That's what I'll see about getting done, and maybe in my next vlog I'll show you guys how the signal performs whilst it's being operated. Okay guys, hope you find this tutorial handy, and I wish you all the best in your construction stages with the signal. If you use the same method as I done, you know, converting these to have upper quadrants and not lower quadrants, then the best of luck with you, and hope it turns out pretty well. So okay guys, that's Whitehousefilms signing off, and thank you for tuning into this editorial. Bye.